Good afternoon, all. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. Yes. It's been a long time coming, but we're happy to be here. I'm happy to present Wagner College's Opera Workshop in our production of Mozart's The Magic Flute. I want to thank the students for the immense hard work that you are about to see. I want to thank all of the voice faculty for their stalwart support of all of their students. I want to thank Dr. Juno for all of his leadership. And last but certainly not least, our orchestra, Giovanni Longo. As a reminder to all of our Zoom attendees, please remain muted throughout the show. Feel free to interact via chat. We're happy to hear from you all. Thank you for joining us, and welcome to the Magic Flute.
Welcome to one and all. Thank you for attending our tale today. In a few moments, you will hear a tale of magic, danger, and romance that will touch all hearts. We begin with a prince in peril.
Find a pretty girl of my own kind. like to fill my net with all the pretty girls I met. Once all the girls were in my net, I keep the fairest as my pet, my sweetheart and my bride-to-be, to love and cherish tenderly. I would bring her cake and sugar plums and be content to eat the crumbs. She'd share my little nest with me, a happier pair could never be.
Who's there?
Tell me who you are, my jolly friend.
Who am I? Silly question. A man like you. Why are you staring at me like that?
Well, I was wondering whether or not you were a human being.
Stay back, I tell you. I have the strength of a giant.
Strength of a giant? Then perhaps it was you who killed this snake!
Snake! Is it alive or is it dead?
But tell me, friend, how did you kill this snake? You have no weapons.
Oh, I don't need any weapons. One good squeeze of my hands is stronger than any weapon.
Then you choked it.
Yeah, never was I as strong as I was today.
Papageno!
Oh, geez, what did I do now? Oh, fair attendants, I brought you my birds.
This time, in return, instead of wine, the queen sends pure, clear water. And instead of sweetbread, she's ordered me to give you this stone. Here's good health to you.
I have to eat stones?
And instead of sweet figs, she's ordered me to lock up your mouth with this padlock.
I'd imagine you'd wonder why the queen punishes you in such a strange way. So that in the future, you may never tell lies to strangers again.
And that you will never boast of heroic deeds achieved by others.
Tell me, did you kill this serpent? Well then, who did?
Prince, it was we who saved you. The great queen sends you this picture of her daughter. If you find that her features be not indifferent to you, then happiness, glory, and honor shall be your destiny. Farewell.
Adieu, Monsieur Papageno.
Don't drink too fast.
Tamino, who has been enraptured by this portrait, has been compelled to find the queen's daughter. The attendants return to inform Tamino that the queen's daughter lies captured by an evil fiend, and it is up to him to save her. As he prepares to set out on his quest, his new friend returns with his mouth locked shut.
Locked fast and tight, then hatred's right.
toast me, buy a toast me, buy a toast me. Nothing less and nothing more. My life I made too high, sail away upon the journey like a thief on the sly.
This precious gift is meant for you.
Well, well, can I see it too?
Hearing the bells of silver singing.
One bird to set them ringing.
Oh, yes, indeed, oh, yes, indeed.
Flute and the toast, magic power.
Monostatos.
Do I wake to new troubles? Oh, this is more bitter than death.
Oh! Hey, you! Daughter of the Queen of the Night!
Queen of the Night? Who are you?
A messenger of the Queen.
My mother? Oh, thank the gods. Your name?
Papageno.
Papageno. Papageno, I remember having heard your name often, but you yourself I never saw.
Nor I you.
Then you know my dear mother?
If you are the Queen's daughter.
Yes, I am.
I'll be the judge of that. Eyes blue. Eyes blue. Lips red. Sure. Red hair. Red hair! Well, everything does seem to be in order here except the hands and feet, for judging by this painting, you don't have any, for none are painted here.
Well, let me see. Yes, this is my portrait, but how did you get it?
That is a long story. I went to the palace, as usual, to make my delivery.
Delivery?
Yes, for years I have caught the rarest birds I can find and delivered them to your mother and her attendants. However, as I went to make my delivery, a man stood in front of me. This man so impressed your mother that she told him to set you free and gave him your portrait. His response was as quick as his love for you.
Love? He loves me then? Oh, say that again. It feels so good to hear the word love.
Well, of course it does. Now, come on, let's go see this handsome prince.
Well, then let's go. Oh, but suppose this is but a trap. Suppose you are but an evil genius of Sarastro.
Me? An evil genius? What are you talking about? I'm not a genius at all.
Forgive me, friend, if I've offended you. You have a tender heart.
Oh, yeah, I have a tender heart, but what good does it do me? Sometimes I just want to pluck all my feathers out when I think that Papageno hasn't found his Papagena yet.
Oh, poor man, then you have no wife.
Not even a girlfriend, let alone a wife.
Be patient, friend. The gods will take care of you. They will send you a wife when the time is right.
If only they'd send her soon.
And man and wife.
We now turn back to our prince in his search for Pamina, as he is visited by three spirits.
Nothing.
your melody be ringing, save us by your magic singing.
Misguided.
and come here right now. Before Sarastro you will bow.
Take a brief intermission.
A quick word to our fair audience.
Hey.
The following act includes depictions of attempted suicide, which may be difficult for some viewers. Please take care of yourselves and each other. And now, let us begin Act Two.
Sacred guests of the gods Osiris and Isis, I do declare that on this day, that today's assembly is one of the most important of our time. Tamino, a prince, waits for us at the entrance of our temple, longing for enlightenment, to watch over this fair youth will be one of our most foremost duties to this day.
He is virtuous?
Virtuous.
Can he keep silent?
He can.
Is he benevolent?
Benevolent. If you consider him worthy, follow my example. And you, friend, teach him to perceive the might of the gods.
Is
basically are. Where we are, well, I might be able to tell you if it wasn't so dark, but I think if we keep going... Ah!
Are you prepared to fight for love and friendship?
I am.
Will you too fight for the love of wisdom?
Fighting's not really my style. And, I don't really demand any wisdom either. I'm more of a child of nature. Sleep, food, and drink is all I need to be satisfied. But if I could find a pretty little wife...
Then that you shall never do unless you undergo our trials.
What do these trials consist of?
You must subject yourself to all our laws and not even fear death.
I'll stay single.
But if Zoroastro has chosen a bride for you, for whom is your perfect match?
Perfect match? Is she young?
Young and beautiful.
What's her name?
Papageno.
Papageno! Oh, well, I'd really like to see her out of sheer curiosity.
See her you may.
But if I see her, do I have to die? Yeah? I'll stay single.
You may see her, but as of yet, you must not speak a single word to her. Will your mind have sufficient strength to control your tongue?
I think so.
You may see her.
And so, with their goals laid out before them, Tamino and Papageno begin their arduous tests. Meanwhile, in the garden where Pamina is resting, the queen appears and gives Pamina a dagger which is meant to murder Sarastro. The queen leaves, and Pamina, aghast at the thought of murder, turns to see Sarastro enter. She begs him not to punish her mother, since her anger is based in grief. Sarastro, taking the dagger, counsels Pamina that he will not seek revenge as it has no place within his dwellings. Now let us turn our gaze towards Tamino and Papageno.
Once more you are left by yourselves. When you hear the trumpet call, go off in that direction. Prince, farewell. Remember, silence. Papageno, anyone who breaks the silence in this place will be punished by the gods with thunder and lightning. Farewell.
Tamino! Oh yeah, this is the good life. If only I were in my straw hut or the woods, at least I'd hear a bird sing once in a while. Should at least be able to talk to myself. La 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 la. Not even a drop of water from these people, let alone anything else.
Is that for me?
Yes, my angel.
Nothing more, nothing less than water. Tell me, are all your guests treated in this fashion?
Surely, my angel.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Come on, Grandma. Let me tell you, I am so bored here. How old are you?
How old?
Yes.
18 years and 2 minutes.
80 years and 2 minutes.
18 years and 2 minutes.
You young angel. Tell me, you got a sweetheart?
Naturally.
And how old is he?
10 years older.
10 years older? A fiery love, I'm sure. What's his name?
Papageno.
Oh, Papageno. Papageno! Well, where is this Papageno?
He's right here, my angel.
So then I am your sweetheart?
Yes, my angel.
Well, tell me, what is your name? I will never speak again. Oh, Tamino, you sure you don't want any of this? All right, you keep playing your flute. I am going to play a little game myself. Mr. Sarastro certainly has a good cook. If I keep getting fed like this, I will gladly keep quiet. Now, let's see if his cellar is as good as his kitchen. Oh, this wine is fit for the gods!
You're here? Heavenly gods, I thank you. I heard the sound of your flute and I called. Its tone as swift as an arrow. But you're sad. You say nothing to your Pamina? Don't you love me anymore? Oh, Papageno, tell me what troubles him. Oh, no, you too. This is worse than death.
I could be quiet if I wanted to. Oh no, you go ahead, I'll catch up.
Oh, what's your hurry? We'll be there in time to be roasted.
Papageno! Oh, if only I knew where I was. Tamino, I swear for the rest of my days I'll never leave your side. Don't leave me here! Tamino! Hello? Tamino?
Miserable! You deserve to wander forever in the dark abysses of the earth. But the gods exempt you from this punishment. However, you shall never experience the heavenly pleasures of the ordained.
I don't care about the ordained. I just want a glass of wine.
Other than this, you have no further wish in this world?
Not so far.
You shall be served.
Ah, marvelous. Heavenly. Divine. I feel as I have wings. But I feel strange. I wish, but what?
I'd give my finest feather to find a pretty wife. Two turtle doves together, we'd share a happy life. And happily then ever after, we'd frolic in gladness and laughter, and all of our dreams would come true. Our life would be heaven for two. We'd frolic in gladness and laughter, and all of our dreams would come true. Our life would be heaven for two. Would be heaven for two. Would be heaven for two.
Now, marriages such as these take some consideration, after all.
Papageno, I advise you, don't hesitate, or you shall be imprisoned here forever.
Imprisoned?
Bread and water shall be your daily diet. You must live without friends or a sweetheart and renounce the world forever.
Renounce the world forever? Drink water? No! I'd rather have an old one than none at all. So here you have my hand with the promise I will always be true to you.
You swear that?
Yes, I swear. Papageno!
Be gone, young woman, for he is not yet worthy.
Oh, my God! Sir, how dare you meddle in my family affairs?
We are now approaching the end of our journey. Let us turn back to the woes of our dear Pamina.
Thank you.
After much hardship and perseverance, our lovers have finally found each other.
Papageno! Dearest, sweetest Papageno, 'tis hopeless. How she has failed me since I was born. Bad luck has trailed me by chattering. I lost my maid, and for this crime I am repaid. For this crime I am repaid. I have tasted of that wine. Since I have seen my lovely bride, all I can do is fume and fret. I am upset, I can't forget. Papageno, pretty darling, Papageno, lovely starling. No more hope, there's no forgiving. Sick and tired am I of living, since my love was all in vain. I shall die to end my pain. Yonder tree shall be my gallows. There I'll hang to end my sorrows. Thus to life I may rebluff. World, good night, I had enough. For I was too harshly treated. All my hopes have been defeated. Very soon I'll cease to be. Lovely maidens, think of me. Lovely maidens, sing of me. Thank you.
Will not someone show compassion? Ere I hang in such a fashion, just reply, say yes or no. Just reply, say yes or no. All is quiet, no one answers. Here I stand deserted, then my end can be averted. Papageno, go ahead, tie the noose and you are dead. Papageno, go ahead, tie the noose and you are dead. Well, I'll wait a while, let's see. I'll wait a while, let's see, till I count from 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. No one came. My lot is cast. So this moment is my last. Not a hand will mine restrain. Fare thee well, thou world of pain. Fare thee well, thou world of pain.
Oh, to battle back, O Pauline, O hear our plea. You live on Mars, and that enough should be. You live on Mars, and that enough should be.
You to your luck with girls will try.
Take your magic bells and play them. Your little sweetheart will obey them.
How very foolishly I acted. I truly must have been distracted. Play out my silver bells, keep ringing, and bring my maiden to my side. And bring my maiden to my side. My maiden here, my sweetheart here, my maiden here.
Upon their parents' blessings bring. Papageno,
Papageno, Papageno, Papageno, Papageno, Papageno, Papageno. For the rest of your days.
Farewell.